In the booming populations of East and Southeast Asia, huge quantities of chicken meat are eaten every day. Chicken is one of their most important sources of protein. But chickens, and also ducks, are often raised in small areas under very unhealthy conditions. An ideal breeding ground for viruses, like the avian influenza virus. In 2003, this virus, commonly known as bird flu, captured the world's attention. It not only kills poultry, but also wild animals, in particular, water birds. It can even kill humans. However, despite often overblown media reports, since 2003, one of the most lethal strains of avian influenza virus, called H5N1, killed 400 people only. In comparison, HIV, the virus that causes AIDS, during the same period of time, killed more than 24 million people. In the case of bird flu, the most common victims are actually birds, not humans. What do we know about avian influenza, and how can we control it? Every year, millions of wild birds undertake impressive journeys. They travel tens of thousands of kilometers between their breeding areas in the north and wintering grounds in the south. They need to migrate in order to survive. Across the globe, there are several bird migratory routes called flyways. One of the most important is the East Asian-Australasian flyway that stretches across 22 countries and is used by 70 million birds of over 300 species. During the long migration, birds face many challenges. One is the loss of critical sites and habitats that serve as vital stepping stones. Another is battling diseases such as avian influenza. Scientists from all around the world are trying to understand how migratory birds can adapt to the rapidly changing environment on their journey and how they can cope with diseases.
Avian influenza viruses, they've been around for a long, long time, and notably in water birds, because both the water birds and the virus, they thrive in water. There are two different forms of the virus: a low pathogenic form that has always been around, and a high pathogenic form that makes birds really sick. And in nearly all cases, we have been able to track that down to something happening in poultry. So what's the story here?
Wild water birds, such as ducks, geese, swans, and shorebirds, can carry the harmless, low pathogenic form of the avian influenza virus. This virus can spread from one bird to another without making the bird sick. But if the virus turns up in a poultry farm where many chickens and ducks live in unhygienic conditions and small areas, the virus can turn into a harmful, high pathogenic form. This harmful virus can spread rapidly among poultry, and most of the infected chickens or ducks die shortly afterwards. However, some of them don't show any symptoms of the disease and continue to spread the virus for a longer period. Finally, the evolved harmful virus can get back to the wild water birds and spread among them. While some studies claim that some wild birds could recover from the infection, the more common outcome is sickness and eventual death.
You can never rule out that a low pathogenic form can evolve to a high pathogenic form in wild birds, but there's very little evidence for that.
It's been very common in East Asia to blame migratory water birds for avian influenza. But in fact, migratory birds are more the victim than the culprit.
For example, in 2005 in Qinghai Lake in China, over 6,000 wild birds died of an avian influenza outbreak. Researchers found that the source of the outbreak was domestic poultry held captive in the vicinity. Scientists agree that wild water birds, including migratory species, naturally carry harmless forms of the virus, and that some species are susceptible to harmful forms. But the real risk factor in the spreading of the avian influenza virus is contact between wild and domestic birds. Nowadays, the risk is higher as the number of poultry is increasing, particularly those in open range areas. At the same time, there are less natural habitats for wild birds. Thus, domestic and wild birds are forced to share the same wetlands.
Migratory water birds often concentrate during the non-breeding season in a small area. So you can find 80% of the world's population in one reservoir, which is the case of the Baikal teal. In the early 1990s, this number was over 1 million ducks. However, in recent years, these numbers have dropped to 300,000, 400,000. So if there was an outbreak, if somehow a virus gets among these birds, it can destroy most of the birds and can lead to the extinction of the whole species.
We often hear in the media that wild migratory birds spread the bird flu. Thus, people mistakenly believe that wild birds introduce the harmful form of the virus into their farms, which can then kill their poultry and even themselves. This fear sometimes leads them to chase the birds and even to kill them.
They go and chase the ducks and the geese away, causing disturbance to the birds. And also, if these birds have some infection already among them, they chase them to other lakes and other parts of the country, which makes the outbreak much worse. Also, sometimes the reaction of the local government is spraying disinfectants into natural water bodies and wetlands, which causes a lot of damage to waterways, and it's completely useless against the influenza virus. Also, it's highly illegal.
The high pathogenic avian influenza virus is a major problem. And the solution is not chasing or killing the wild birds, nor is it disinfecting or poisoning natural wetlands. These actions are useless against high pathogenic avian influenza outbreaks. So what can we do? The solution is to improve biosecurity. Biosecurity means protecting poultry by preventing diseases like avian influenza virus from entering the farm. It also means protecting poultry farms and wild birds in the surrounding wetlands by stopping the disease from leaving affected farms. Biosecurity does not only benefit farmers by keeping their poultry healthy, but helps to sustain the environment and keep wildlife and humans free of disease. Poultry farmers still remember the times before applying biosecurity protocols.
Nhà có nuôi 500 vịt và 100 gà rồi mới nó bị chết không rõ nguyên nhân thành hao cả 20-30%.
Trước kia là tình trạng của nhà anh em thì chưa có được phân chia rõ rệt là giữa khu sinh hoạt và khu ấp nở, nó vẫn liên tục với nhau, nó không có phân cách được.
There are a few simple steps we can take to improve biosecurity. The poultry farmer should disinfect or change shoes when entering the farm. The farm should be kept free of droppings that could spread the virus. Dead poultry should be removed and incinerated or buried deep in the ground to avoid the transmission of the virus to healthy birds. The water and air entering into the poultry farm should be filtered. Water contaminated by infected poultry must not have access to natural wetlands unless treated properly. The poultry farmer should change clothes when entering and leaving the farm. Farm clothes and tools should be regularly disinfected. Similarly, the equipment used to transport poultry products should also be cleaned to avoid the transmission of the virus to other poultry farms. Farmers have to make sure that wildlife and poultry are strictly separated. Poultry infections should be immediately reported to authorities to take prompt action.
That is a very simple and highly doable solution to the problem that would benefit our economies and would benefit wildlife.
Từ nhà người ta về thấy người ta như chuồng trại này kia, thấy về chuồng trại sạch sẽ, mình về cũng làm sạch sẽ và đàng hoàng cho người ta. Thấy gà người ta dịch người ta không chết á.
Finally, these biosecurity measures protect wild birds, including endangered migratory species from becoming infected and dying unnecessarily. Let's work together to combat the threat of avian influenza virus so that our migratory birds may continue their extraordinary journeys.